Hi everyone, this is a special episode of our eSports show. In the next few minutes, you'll learn of the major changes in the Wargaming League and consequentially the team battle mode. It's time for global changes in tank eSports. What changes? First of all, the battle type. Now all the games will use the new attack-defense mode. It's similar to assault mode, but has two bases. So one team has to defend two bases, and the other one can capture either of them. Especially for this, several maps were remade, and six will be used in the league in the new season. The teams will have two choices of setup, six Tier 8 tanks and one Tier 6, or 5/8 and 2/7. Now every player can affect the outcome of the battle, and this is a great advantage of the new format. The matches are also carried out differently. Pavel Varabi will share the details.
There will be no ties. Now, a league match consists of 8 battles on 2 maps. Each 2 battles, the teams switch sides and play until one gets 5 wins. If no winner is selected after 8 battles, a tiebreaker is held. It's a battle on a different map. The winner of this battle will win the whole match. The right to choose the side during the tiebreak goes to the team with the fastest victory during an attack. If neither team won during an attack, it goes to the team that dealt most damage when attacking. So now it's not good to stay on the defensive all the time. The team that plays more aggressively will have the advantage. We conducted lots of tests recently, some involved pro players. So all the changes to the format aren't random. We should ask the pro players to get their opinion on the matter.
I like the new features, of course. The attack-defense idea was pretty obvious. Many online games have competitions held almost like this. Wargaming has invited 6 or 7 players from top teams, and the format was actively discussed. Something was approved, something declined, and as a result, we got this new format we'll see. First of all, the attack-defense format is good because we won't see much standing around. There'll be some positional attacks. Each round will have some kind of attack. Both the attacking and the defending team can go on the offensive.
We will see lots of different tactics. Since being on the defensive isn't always an option, much depends on the map control, and if you give up the good positions to the attackers, you will be simply gunned down. So because of this, the team that's defending the bases will often have to attack and use offensive strategies. You'll have to act and make a battle plan in advance.
The format is better for players because there will be no similar boring strategies. For example, there was a strategy for Ruinberg's bottom base. You stay put and nothing can move you because such defense is impenetrable. Now such a thing is impossible. Each map will have several attack options thanks to the two bases, and the defending opponent has to guess where you will go. Maybe they will try to catch you on the first base, maybe the second, or maybe divide forces. This is a great advantage for the attack, I think. The tactics will change from one battle to the other. There will be no all-purpose strategies. It will be important to act according to the situation.
There are a few interesting moments. First, we will see new Tier 6-7 vehicles that will allow us to see new setups, tactics, and rollout. Maybe even the artillery will return, along with tank destroyers. Also, the captains will have to learn to drive vehicles, since driving a Tier 1 isn't an option now. They will have to drive a real combat vehicle while thinking about battle tactics. This is pretty hard. Given that most captains used to only drive a Tier 1 before, I think some teams will face real problems because of this.
Playing will be much harder now, in my opinion, because all of the previous templates will be useless. In fact, the new format introduction is very good for young teams which weren't known before. An active practice for the new format can bring good results from the very first season.
A great role is now played by teamwork, since there is now more combat units on the field. Many teams, including our own, will have changes in the lineup, because we now must have 7 players that are good with the vehicles. The core of the team won't change much. 1 or 2 players will leave and be replaced with 2 or 3 stronger ones.
Of course, the higher requirements of this format couldn't leave the team's lineup unchanged. Even our team will have changes. Now I will act not as the captain, but as a manager and coach. We recruited 2 young, motivated players from Unity instead of Tier 1s. They are Anatolich and Rino. So Unity also had certain changes. They recruited 3 players from Mind, as far as I know. I don't know where Mind will get new players, but I think these changes will affect all Gold Series teams.
Given the great changes in the teams, and that many will have to learn to play together from scratch, many will have problems at first, but it's worth it. Now we'll see a cheerful tank massacre in every battle, and numerous tactics will appear. That's what we've been waiting for.
I think the spectators will be interested starting from the first tour of the league. The tactics are pretty raw, and the teams will constantly surprise each other. I think the results will be unpredictable.